Welcome, everyone. I'm Fred Lugo, the director of Coming of Age. And did you know that this marks our 45th year of service in Travis County? That's right. Since 1972, we've been serving you, and you've been serving the citizens of our community. And we've been recognizing you for your service to our many partner nonprofit agencies and programs. So to kick off this year of service, we thought we'd use a theme that harkens back to the 60s. It was an era of feeling groovy. Because the summer is almost upon us, we thought we'd go with the theme Summer of Service. And actually, in actuality, you serve year-round. But we thought the theme Summer of Service would be fun. So that's why you see some of us in 60s tie-dye outfits. You see my shirt up here, okay? And you see the little groovy buses, your centerpieces, right in the middle of your table there. Fun, isn't it? That was a great time. And as you know, Coming of Age is part of Travis County. So I'd like to recognize our Travis County VIPs. Deborah Britton, Chief Deputy for Travis County Health and Human Services. Ross Stevens, Community Services Division Director for Travis County Health and Human Services. And from the Travis County Commissioner's Court, our friend, Margaret Gomez. And I know the Commissioner would like to say a few words on behalf of Travis County.
Thank you so much, Fred. It is indeed a great pleasure to be here with you today. I always look forward to these luncheons. It's one of my favorite luncheons that I am invited to attend. And I look forward to this luncheon every year because it's so good to see that there's a future for all of us, no matter where we are in our life. And it's always a pleasure to make that motion to approve this program for HHS in Travis County. It is the best vote that I ever take every year. So thank you very much.
Thank you, Commissioner Gomez. Now I'd like to introduce our incredible Board of Directors and Advisory Council. They've been serving as your hosts and have been assisting to accomplish our mission. Let me introduce them. Their names are up on the screen. Alice Latino, President. Richard Bondi, Treasurer. Penny Seidel. Beth Tracy. Nola Marie Dilworth. Graham Duncan. Ann Fertitta. Jody Lynn Gray. Cindy Gunderson. Dr. Karen Hayward, Jim Spencer, John Thomas, Mary Voorhees, and Christina Williams. Thank you, Board and Advisory Council, for your support. Big round of applause. Thank you. I'd also like to thank the volunteers from Travis County Health and Human Services, local senior centers, and AISD who have been helping with today's event. Their names are in the thank you section of your program. Also, a huge thanks to Michael Reeves, photojournalism teacher at James Bowie High School, and his student photographers. I'd now like to ask Alice Latino, our board president, to come to the stage to do another special thank you.
Without the support of Travis County, our grantors, our donors, and our sponsors, this event would not be possible. This year, they include up on the screen our platinum sponsors, IBM and Westminster Manor, our gold sponsor, the Helen S. and John J. McKetta Jr. Charitable Foundation, our silver sponsors, Mud Puppies, Texas Oncology, and WellMed Charitable Foundation, our bronze sponsors, Dr. and Mrs. Tom Seidel, Ann Fertitta, and Heavenly Care Home Health. Please join me in a round of applause as we extend a huge thanks to the sponsors of this event. Our donors provided wonderful door prizes for this year's event. They include Autumn Leaves of South Austin, Richard Bondi, Nola Marie Dilworth, Graham Duncan, Jody Lynn Gray, Cindy Gunderson, Karen Hayward, Francisca Lugo, Fred Lugo, Deborah and Sam Price, Jim Spencer, John Thomas, Mary Voorhees, and Christina Williams. Again, please join me in a round of applause for these. Throughout the year, I've had the privilege and opportunity to hear about the incredible work that you do. This past year, your story of service was all about strengthening our community and helping nonprofit organizations and agencies achieve their missions. This past year, you were part of 422 volunteers who provided 74,419 hours of service at 73 nonprofit, faith-based, and public agencies in Travis County. 317 of you served through RSVP in disaster services, independent living, education, hunger, veterans services, fundraising for nonprofits, health services, and by recruiting and managing volunteers for nonprofits. The impact of your volunteer service, wait for this, translated to an added value of, we need a big drum roll here, $1,871,638 for Travis County taxpayers. Woo! Amazing. Amazing. This past year, we also developed the Be Ready Project. 17 volunteers partnered with the Travis County Department of Veterans Services and VFW Post 8925 to provide disaster readiness bags to veterans in Pilot Knob, an area recently hit with historic and deadly flooding. 500 bags were distributed to veterans and families of veterans at various distribution events. Of course, we are not leaving you out. You can be ready too. When you registered this morning, you should have received a Be Ready bag. I see them all over the place. They look wonderful. They have vital information about being ready in the event of a disaster, and we encourage you to take a look through the entire bag. Fred, staff, and volunteers, on behalf of the Board and Advisory Council, thank you for your incredible work. Everyone deserves a round of applause. And now I turn the podium back over to Fred.
Thank you, Alice. And that was just the tip of the iceberg. You all know that. Page 8 in your program lists more of your incredible achievements from this past year. So what can I tell you as we look ahead? The Austin metropolitan area has the fastest growing older adult population and second fastest growing senior population in the country. We know the needs in our community will keep growing. So we're continually striving to provide new and innovative ways to inspire and enable you to affect change in our community. So to get the year going, we thought we'd kick it off with a volunteer recruitment contest. Some of you may recall several years ago, we offered a volunteer recruitment contest. We're bringing it back this year, but with a twist. We will offer cash prizes to our nonprofit partners whose current volunteers recruit the largest number of new volunteers. So, this is going to your nonprofit where you serve. This is a good way for volunteers to work with their nonprofit organizations to increase volunteer numbers and advance their missions. To be eligible, the nonprofit must be a coming-of-age partner, plus all newly recruited volunteers must be registered and actively reporting their volunteer activity with coming-of-age. Agency volunteers must recruit a minimum of 10 new volunteers who must serve at least twice during the recruitment period from July 1st, coming up, through March 31st of 2018. The three agencies who recruit the most volunteers will receive first prize, $300, second prize, $200, and third prize, $100. Staff will be following up with all current partner agencies to provide more details, but you're welcome to contact our office to find out more information. We also want to announce that we will be hosting our Learning Lab on July 26th. It's a one-day workshop about recruiting skilled volunteers who are 50 and older, managing organizational change, and building capacity. For those of you who are here representing nonprofit organizations, this is a great learning opportunity on how to harness the talents, the skills, and passions of people 50 and older, as well as discover methods and strategies for retaining volunteers who are 50 and older. Class size is limited. It is free to our nonprofit partners. Did you hear that? It's free. So please check in with LaDonna Woodley, back over here, to make your reservation. Now I'd like to introduce our MC. Our MC has a very long history of involvement in community and charitable organization. He serves on numerous boards and advisory councils, most notably the Coming of Age Advisory Council, and formerly when we were known as our SVP. Football officiating is one of his passions. As a line judge and head linesman, he has officiated high school football for 31 years. Is that right? 31 years? Wow. And he has been a member of the chain crew for Big 12 conference officials during UT home football games. Yay, hook 'em. He has received national recognition for his work. He is a past recipient of the National Weather Association's Weathercaster of the Year Award, and he is also a five-time winner of the Texas Associated Press Best Weathercast Award, and has been voted Austin's Best Weathercaster by readers of the Austin Chronicle for 16 years. Ladies and gentlemen, our MC, Mr. Jim Spencer.
Thank you very much, Fred. It's so good to be back with you all. I had to disappear for a couple of years because of that drought. But we've had great rainfall, 2015, 2016, and now 2017. We're right at normal. Our yards are green, free water. Don't you love it? That also means, usually, when we're green this late headed into the summertime, that our average high temperatures are a little bit lower. So maybe not the hottest summer in the world again this year. However, I think the only summer we've been below normal was 2007. Every single summer since then, we've been hotter than normal. Just kind of the way things are changing in our climate right now. Well, thank you all very, very much for having me here. Fred mentioned that I've got a long history with Coming of Age and the Retire and Senior Volunteer Program. In fact, I started on the advisory council of RSVP somewhere in the two-decade-ago range, I do believe. I felt like a little bit of an outsider because I wasn't even old enough to volunteer with RSVP. But now I have my AARP card. I feel like I'm part of the club. I really feel like part of the club now. And I'm still proud to be on the Coming of Age Advisory Council. Man, I want to talk weather so bad. But I know we have to get on with it. So much interesting stuff going on in the weather. Speaking of the summer, I do want to mention one thing. A lot of you do volunteer with senior services. I am also working with, in our summer fan drive, Family Elder Care. I know many of you probably work with Family Elder Care. We have a fan drive going on right now. If any of the seniors that you work with, or even people with disabilities, or families, low-income families with children maybe you volunteer with, if they have an air conditioner that doesn't run or they don't run it because they can't afford the electricity bill, and they need a fan, a box fan or two, let Family Elder Care know. 512-4594-FAN is the phone number, by the way. See me afterwards if you need that again. It's 512-4594-FAN. We want to make sure everybody gets a fan this summer, all right, or two if they need. All right, thanks for my plug there, because we are our big event next Friday, by the way, for the Summer Fan Drive. Love to have you join us there. Well, let us begin with our awards ceremony. This, I get to do the fun part here. This is the most fun thing I think that I do every year, is being able to be a part of handing out these awards to people who are so, so very deserving. And the first thing we're going to do is recognize those who have been making a difference in our community for 15 and 20 years through RSVP and coming of age. We have 9 volunteers being recognized for 15 years of service. They are Nita Arnold, Dorothy Carey, Boyd Covey, Patricia Gilker, Judith Lindfors, Aurelia Manchaca, Carolyn Nunley, Helen Poust, and Gwen Cederholm. Would you all please come up here and join Fred over here on the left side of the stage? While they come up, let me tell you about Nita. Nita Arnold serves through Village Christian. Dorothy Carey entertains others through Austin Rockin' Line Dancers. Boyd Covey is a driver with Drive a Senior Northeast. Patricia Gilker serves at St. David's North. Judith Lindfors volunteers at Mike's Place and Meals on Wheels Central Texas. Aurelia Manchaca serves through Parker Lane United Methodist. Carolyn Nunley volunteers at the UT Performing Arts Center. Helen Poust serves at Brackenridge Hospital. And Gwen Cederholm is a driver for Drive a Senior West Austin. To all 9 of you, we say thank you for your 15 years of service to our community. And look right that direction, and we're going to get a photo of all of our groups as they come up, just like we're doing here right now. Let me tell you about those being honored tonight or this afternoon for 20 years of service. They are Helen Anderson, Marjorie Beeman, Gertha Billingsley, Edna Bloomquist, Donald Campbell, Beatrice Haig, Alma Harrington, Mary Hermes, Flora Thompson, and Lucy Walker. Would you all please come up? Helen Anderson volunteers at the Senior Activity Center on Lamar and is secretary of their advisory board. Marjorie Beeman, what can you say about Marjorie? She is absolutely everywhere. AISD, American Youth Works, Bob Bullock Museum, Meals on Wheels, just a few places where she's made a difference in our community. Gertha Billingsley assists with Meals on Wheels nutrition program at Conley Guerrero. Edna Bloomquist is an information desk volunteer with South Austin Hospital. Donald Campbell was the manager of the South Austin Hospital gift shop and is now an honorary lifetime volunteer. And Beatrice Haig assists with medical records at Seton Community Health Center. Alma Harrington serves as the vice president of the advisory board for the Senior Activity Center on Lamar. Mary Hermes makes quilts for Dell Children's Hospital and assists AISD in Dell Valley with various projects. Flora Thompson volunteers as a docent with the Paramount Theater. And Lucy Walker volunteers with Conley Guerrero Meals on Wheels Nutrition Program. Please join me in a round of applause to thank these incredible volunteers. And now, celebrating 25 years of service with us are John Conrado, Martha Johnson, and Austin Phelps. Would you come up and join Fred right here? John Conrado has served as the Drive a Senior South Austin Board President for the last 7 years, recently just stepping down last year. He's also served on many committees as a driver and a donor for Drive a Senior South. Martha Johnson leads approximately 40 older adults in Conley Guerrero's Exercise One class every Monday, Wednesday, and Friday. She encourages her peers to live a healthy lifestyle. And Austin Phelps volunteers twice a week with Learning Ally as an audio book reader and recently turned 90 years old. We are so honored to have all of you as part of our coming of age and RSVP family. Our next award category, the 1,000 and 2,000 Hours of Service Award for this past year. 13 volunteers served over 1,000 hours during the past year. Would these volunteers please come to this stage? Andy Anthony, Nola Marie Dilworth, Suzanne Fought, Penny Goering, Eleanor Langsdorf, Patricia Lovett, Dixie Lynch, Bill Miller, Joan Morby, Don Sagert, Lynn Sampsel, Ruth Shane, and Michael Wadino. Andy Anthony serves with Texas Search and Rescue. Nola Marie Dilworth volunteers with Family Elder Care, the Care Communities, Hospice Austin, and is a member of the Coming of Age Advisory Council. Suzanne Fought serves at Central Texas Food Bank, South Austin Hospital, and the City of Austin CERT program. Penny Goering serves with Texas Search and Rescue. Eleanor Langsdorf volunteers with Drive a Senior North Central, Foundation Communities, and Project Linus. Patricia Lovett serves at Seton Northwest. Dixie Lynch also serves at Seton Northwest. Bill Miller is a driver with Drive a Senior West Austin. Joanne Morby serves at Seton Northwest. Don Sagert is a driver with Drive a Senior North Central. Lynn Sampsel volunteers at Seton Southwest. Ruth Shane serves at South Austin Hospital. And Michael Wadino serves at the American Red Cross. Did you know that 1,000 hours of service per year is about 20 hours of service a week? That is dedication. Let's give them a big hand. And now we're up to our 2,000 Hours of Service Award for this past year. 8 more volunteers being recognized today. Let's have Marjorie Beeman come back up. Althea Conrado. I'm going to get it right, Althea. I've known you too long not to get that right. Hal Ferguson. Karen Ferguson. Brandon Goering. Delwyn Goss. Sean Hanstrider. And Nancy Walker. All come forward, please. Now, 2,000 hours a year really amounts to a full-time position. Let me tell you about these Elite Eight. We just honored Marjorie Beeman for her 20 years of service. We're also recognizing her for serving over 2,000 hours this past year. Some of the other places where she's made a difference include Austin Council for the Blind, Operation Blue Santa, and the Conley Guerrero Senior Activity Center. And I know that we're not even mentioning half of what Marjorie does because I work with her sometimes in a mentorship program, actually a career day that she puts together for elementary schools all over the city. So she does a great job organizing that, and that's a lot of work. Althea Conrado, a knitter, has been knitting since she was age 5. As a pre and early teenager during World War II, Althea was given permission from the Red Cross to knit special gloves for machine gunners. Her gloves allowed the soldiers to keep their hands warm and still operate their weapons. Today, her knitted lap blankets are donated to the patients at the AMED Community Hospice of the North Area. Hal and Karen Ferguson serve as volunteer co-managers of the South Austin Hospital Gift Shop. They order product, schedule, and manage all gift shop volunteers, and they are the key to the gift shop's fundraising. They've been with Coming of Age over 10 years. Brandon Goering volunteers with Texas Search and Rescue. He's also known as Texar. He's been with them since 2005. He's a key player when first response teams are needed during National natural disasters and emergency crisis situations. Brandon coordinates Techstars' technology efforts, is the planning chief, and serves on the board of directors. Delwyn Goss consistently volunteers over 2,000 hours a year at several organizations around Austin, which include the Austin Humane Society, Emancipet, Florence's Comfort House, Florence is here today, the Montopolis Community Alliance, the Austin Animal Center, and the City of Austin's Electric Board. Sean Hahnstrider is a key volunteer with Texas Search and Rescue. He serves as chairman of the board and operations chief. Sean also serves on the board of directors for the Austin Rodeo. He consistently donates over 2,000 hours each year to ensure the success of these organizations. And finally, Nancy Walker. She volunteers with the Funeral Consumers Alliance of Central Texas. In addition to being their volunteer executive director, Nancy assists in almost every other capacity to ensure the success of their program. She is truly dedicated to their mission and passionate about their cause. When someone volunteers over 2,000 hours in just 1 year, you know that their service is one of passion. They're an inspiration to all of us. Thank you all for your service. This year, we add Olga Barrera, Gwen Churchill, Nola Marie Dilworth, Caroline Farrell, Alma Harrington, Dorothy Hervey, Gigi Klepper, and Cora Sutton to the growing list of volunteers receiving the President's Volunteer Service Award. Would you all please come to the front? Established in 2003 under President George W. Bush, the President's Council on Service and Civic Participation recognizes the valuable contributions that volunteers are making in our communities and encourages more people to serve. The Council created the President's Volunteer Service Award program as a way to thank and honor Americans who, by their demonstrated commitment and example, inspire others to engage in volunteer service. Continued today, the President's Volunteer Service Award recognizes United States citizens and lawfully admitted permanent residents of the United States who have achieved over 4,000 hours or more of volunteer service over the course of a lifetime. These award recipients are receiving a certificate as well as a Presidential Volunteer Service pin. Olga Barrera has been a coming-of-age volunteer for over 11 years and volunteers at the information desk at South Austin Hospital. Gwen Churchill has been a coming-of-age volunteer for almost 9 years and volunteers at the Seton Southwest ER, the gift shop, and for special events. Nola Marie Dilworth has been a coming-of-age volunteer for almost 5 years. She volunteers with Family Elder Care, the Care Communities, Hospice Austin, and has recently joined the Coming-of-Age Advisory Council. We're glad to have her. Today, we also honor one of our volunteers, Carolyn Farrell, who passed away on May 10th. Her husband, Chuck, is accepting on her behalf. Carolyn volunteered. Yeah. Carolyn volunteered with Coming of Age and the South Austin Hospital for 17 years at the information desk, and she will be missed. Our condolences, Chuck. Alma Harrington has been a coming-of-age volunteer for 20 years and serves at the Vice President of the Advisory Board for the Senior Activity Center on Lamar. Dorothy Hervey has been a coming-of-age volunteer for almost 10 years and assists at the coffee shop at the Conley Guerrero Senior Activity Center. Gigi Klepper has been a coming-of-age volunteer for over 12 years, currently volunteers with Drive a Senior Pflugerville and with the Corner Cafe at Seton Medical Center. And Cora Sutton, a coming-of-age volunteer for almost 10 years, volunteering at the Conley Guerrero Senior Activity Center. Congratulations to our President's Award members, winners, and we thank you for your service. And now, ladies and gentlemen, this is truly the highlight of this event, our 2017 Spirit of Service Awards. The Spirit of Service Awards were created to acknowledge the success and achievement of a very limited number of volunteers for exceptional contributions to the community. Our Spirit of Service Award recipients receive awards from volunteering that are deeply personal and spring from a desire that they have to help those in need. Penny Goering, would you please come up to the stage? Penny was nominated for the Spirit of Service Award by Texas Search and Rescue. Penny has been volunteering at Texas Search and Rescue since 2014. She has received 6 certifications in basic incident command systems and obtained CPR AED training and certification, wilderness first aid, man tracking and ground search and rescue technician certifications. Penny has also accrued over 1,500 hours of service in just 2.5 years with the organization. TechSAR was deployed for almost 100 days in the past 2 years, including our historic Memorial Day and Halloween floods, the Caldwell County hot air balloon crash, and numerous missing person searches and life imminent incidents. Penny not only assists with organizational administration and membership for over 20 members statewide, she is also an integral part in command incidents, managing documentation, communications, and other tasks critical to emergency response. She has worked in partnership with numerous organizations, including the Texas Forestry Service, county commissioners, the Office of Emergency Management, and FAIR and law enforcement to ensure TechSAR utilized resources effectively and enabled volunteers to make the greatest impact. She is the heart of TechSAR. Let's hear her story.
Thank you all for coming out this evening to help with this search effort. We're looking for a missing child and a missing woman that were out on a hike earlier today.
I volunteer at TechSAR because it's something that needs to be done.
As Charlie mentioned, he was snacking on some Cheetos.
There are a lot of people out there who get lost, are in trouble, need help.
TechSAR, Texas Search and Rescue, is a nonprofit organization made up completely of volunteer members who are certified in different disciplines of search and rescue.
He's 12.
I've always been a volunteer person.
Not Mason, it's Lance.
Yes.
She is a volunteer's volunteer. She's beyond dedicated, she's committed.
The purpose of the Coming of Age program is to keep adults over the age of 50 engaged in the community through volunteerism.
I thought search and rescue, everybody had to put a pack on their back and hike out in the wilderness and keep going as long as they could. But I come to find out that there's plenty of other things to do.
We are only deployed by law enforcement.
You can be doing documentation, you can be doing communications, you can be doing mapping, you can be doing a lot of things.
We do operate only on donations, so each member is responsible for paying for their dues, paying for their certifications and their uniforms, and then whatever equipment they choose that they feel that they need to do. So there is a financial commitment. Water rescue, we have a canine team, we're working on a drone team.
I do not go out on the field, so I do not get the immediate reward that the searchers get when they find someone, something that'll help a family.
Without people like Penny, without our member volunteers, there would be no TechSAR.
It's just the emotion and the care and the consideration that this group of people gives to fellow Texans is just amazing, and I'm so very proud to be part of it.
Penny, congratulations to you. Thank you for providing this valuable service to our community, and for that, we present you now with the 2017 Spirit of Service Award. Martha Langford is our next 2017 Spirit of Service Award recipient. Martha, please come to the stage while I talk about you a little bit. As an active member of the Gus Garcia Recreation Center and community, Martha serves as a stakeholder on the Friends of Gus Garcia Advisory Board. During the 2016 holidays, her contributions and commitment came in the form of donated canned goods for their Thanksgiving food giveaway. Her efforts resulted in more than 50 families receiving full resources for Thanksgiving dinners. Along with her services within the center, she has continually served as a leader and supporter for their neighborhood community garden, the senior program, and neighborhood park. As a leading voice in their senior program, she serves with the best interest and needs of the program participants of over 80 seniors. Please direct your attention to the screen as we take a look at Martha's work at the Gus Garcia Recreation Center.
Over here we have snap peas and the remains of mustard greens and more cilantro.
When we first started meeting about what to do in the senior garden, I was the only one that grew up on a farm. I had knowledge and experience with plants and taking care of a garden that no one else had at that time.
Martha Langford she's a member of our senior board as well as our senior activity program. I've really had the opportunity to see how much work that she's contributed firsthand, whether it's our community garden.
I try to be the glue that holds the senior garden together. I try to make sure that the senior garden is halfway taken care of by different volunteers.
Without volunteers like Martha, it would make it really difficult to be able to run the programs we have. Not just staffing, but just the aspect of how much community involvement is it entails for us to be able to run these programs.
Of course, we are looking at the recreation centers to promote healthy aging and make sure that there's not that social isolation that we find when adults start to age.
When people get older, if they're single, if they've lost their spouses, and many of the people that come to us do, the exercise portion of the program, exercise activities that will use nearly every muscle in our bodies to keep us going and to keep the whole part of the body active. My husband loves to be hugged by all the women, and they all seem to be able to hug him without getting upset, you know. Well, I cheat sometimes. I like to dance and sing. I like to do the grito. You know what the grito is? Ay, 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 ay! You know, I'm better at that than most men.
Martha, we honor you today with our community's Spirit of Service Award. Congratulations, Martha. Our next Spirit of Service Award recipient is Eleanor Langsdorf. Eleanor, come on up. Let me tell you a little about Eleanor. She was nominated by two agencies, Drive a Senior North Central and Foundation Communities. This past year, Eleanor provided 426 rides and drove 4,839 miles for Drive a Senior. As a volunteer, she provides her own vehicle at her expense to provide this free service to seniors no longer able to drive themselves. She is also one of their office volunteers who handles phone calls from clients and sets up ride scheduling. Additionally, she is an indispensable volunteer for two of the volunteer programs at Foundation Communities, the Community Tax Centers, and Ensure Central Texas. Since 2006, Eleanor has served 2,673 hours in their community tax centers and 440 hours in their Ensure Central Texas programs. She has personally assisted 3,303 low-income families in Austin. She's enrolled 220 households in health insurance. She's filed tax returns for 3,083 households. I can't even do my own. And get this, she's helped families recover $5.3 million in tax refunds. She is very passionate about service. She is committed to the organization's mission and is a hardworking member of their team. Please turn your attention to the screen.
I especially like volunteering for foundation communities through their tax prep program because it helps people get a service they desperately need without paying some of the outrageous fees that are charged by other providers.
Having Eleanor on our team makes a huge difference to our clients.
For the past 3 or 4 years, I've been what's called a member of the volunteer leadership team, which means I help other preparers answer any questions they may have or explain to clients what the issue is that they're having difficulties with.
Eleanor actually volunteers for the community tax centers and Insure Central Texas.
She does so much in the community, so much for not only our program, but for foundation communities, for Drive a Senior. She works in so many different capacities, and the fact that she was nominated by both organizations this year, that's never happened. It's never happened in the history of the Coming of Age program, Spirit of Service Award.
I've been driving a senior since about September 2005.
The biggest thing we do is provide transportation for seniors who no longer drive. We take them to doctor's appointments, to run errands, go to the grocery store, with the biggest thing getting them to their medical appointments. And we also provide some other services, with our mission being to help seniors remain independent and living in their own home.
We do most of our drives between 9 and 3, so we avoid the heavy traffic areas. And as a driver, you can choose what part of town you want to drive in and how far you're willing to drive.
Without someone like Eleanor, we might not be able to make all the rides and provide as many as we do. We would need more help in the office than we get. We have usually volunteers helping with the phones because sometimes one person just can't keep up with the calls.
As a driver for Drive a Senior, I work with one of the clients who has been a Drive a Senior client for about 2 years now. Mostly I take her to doctor offices, but sometimes I take her to government offices. And she is a Drive a Senior client, and usually we do go to the doctor, but once in a while we go somewhere else.
Eleanor, congratulations to you. We honor you today with our Community Spirit of Service Award. And would you please tell me where those low traffic areas are between 9 and 3? Thank you. Congratulations again, Eleanor. Well, to all of our Spirit of Service Award recipients, we thank you for the difference you make and the impact you have on our wonderful community. America has a long and proud tradition of volunteer service, and now more than ever, volunteers in Travis County through Coming of Age and RSVP are renewing their commitment to helping others and making new connections that bring us closer together as families and as neighbors and as communities. Again, a huge thanks today to all the donors and sponsors who made today's recognition special. To our special guests for joining us here today, to our award winners, most especially, for your service and for helping honor our 45 years of service in Travis County, and to the staff on behalf of the Advisory Council, a special thank you to you all for making this event come together. You all share an undue portion of the burden in putting this event together today, and as an Advisory Council member, I think I can speak for all of us saying we really appreciate you. This is a fantastic event. Thanks to you. Am I right, Alice? Okay. I close by extending a sincere thank you for your service to each and every one of you. You truly are heroes that are always ready and willing and able to contribute your time and talents and energy to helping other people in our community. Your acts of service are making a huge difference in the lives of thousands of people in our community. So let's start this summer of service by making it a full year of service, and we'll see everybody back again next year with even more hours to add to your tally. See you later. See you next year.